This evening, a Requiem so dramatic it gives opera a run for its money. Brace yourself for Verdi's Requiem at the BBC Proms. Welcome to the Royal Albert Hall for the unmistakable drama of Verdi's Requiem. This emotional roller coaster isn't just a mournful ode for the departed, though. It is a thunderous celebration of life and death. Let's have a bit of background. Verdi was moved to write it after the death of his friend, the writer Alessandro Manzoni, an important figure in Italian society, who Verdi considered to be a living saint. When he heard of his demise, he wrote, "I would like to compose a mass for the dead to be performed next year on the anniversary of his death." And that is exactly what he did. Verdi already had superstar status in Italy at the time, thanks to his hugely popular operas, including La Traviata and Aida. And so, although it is a Requiem mass, it has been described as the grandest opera Verdi never wrote because of its drama and its depth. Early on comes the Dies Irae, which you will definitely recognise. It's the crashing and chaotic chorus depicting the day of wrath, which carries through then softly to the sung lacrimosa mourning the dead. Now, this Requiem is as much a theatrical experience as it is a religious one, and although this might seem like a bit of an odd thing to say, it's actually great fun too. When you witness these monumental forces, the orchestra, the double choir, the soloists, well, just you wait. Verdi himself conducted the premiere on the first anniversary of Manzoni's death 150 years ago in Milan. And it has a special connection with this place, because just 1 year later, Verdi conducted the British premiere on this very stage. Tonight, it's a double choir for double the drama. We have the BBC National Chorus of Wales and the Crouch End Festival Chorus, who will work against one another, creating melodic and rhythmic tension and unease. Three of tonight's soloists making their Proms debuts, soprano Latonia Moore, tenor SeokJong Baek, and bass Soloman Howard. Karen Cargill, tonight's mezzo-soprano, no stranger to singing the Requiem on this stage. She performed it here in 2015. Tonight's conductor is Ryan Bancroft from California, principal conductor of the BBC National Orchestra of Wales. We begin with the introit. Grant them eternal rest, O Lord.
Thank you.
Verdi's Requiem here at the BBC Proms. The final movement there, Libera Me, with Latonia Moore's plea, Deliver Me, O Lord, from Eternal Death, and that powerful fugue to end. American soprano Latonia Moore making her Proms debut. Tenor SeokJong Baek from South Korea, his Proms debut as well. Scottish mezzo Karen Cargill. And bass Soloman Howard, again, Proms debut for him. Verdi continued to be involved with performances of the Requiem throughout his life, often conducting it himself. Music that showcases the enormity of life, the vastness of experience and emotion that we can have within it. The drama of those two choruses, the BBC National Chorus of Wales and the Crouch End Festival Chorus, the BBC National Orchestra of Wales, all conducted by Ryan Bancroft. From Requiem to Romance. Next up this Sunday night on BBC Four and iPlayer, join us for a fabulous tribute to the jazz singer Sarah Vaughan, with a starry lineup of singers performing songs she made famous, including If You Could See Me Now and Broken Hearted Melody. So we'll see you then. Good night.